I, Charles Dickens, sitting here with you as you wait for me to take up these books of mine one by one and turn their leaves so you may listen to me, I am conscious of a strange feeling, for it was in just such a little room as this that I first took up my pen to write these books, with in my mind's eye all of you, as you would one day be sitting there reading them. But since then, my horizons have expanded prodigiously. I have travelled, as an actor of my own works, over the world, from garish lights to garish lights, from thousands of people to more thousands, whose mighty roar, when I took the stage, almost frightened me, until, as I stood there about to turn over the first page, they became as still as mice, and I knew they were my friends. Thousands upon thronging thousands, from that first performance on the 27th of December, 1853, in the Town Hall, Birmingham, to the unforgettable night of the 20th of April, 1868, in the Steinway Hall, New York City. Now the wheel has turned full circle. I am once more in my little room, but this time I do not write for you. Through a miracle of science wedded to art, I speak to you. Sit, my friends, as my own family have sat before now, round our fire at Gad's Hill, our home in Kent. Sit while I turn the pages and tell you a tale or two. Your servant and friend, Charles John Huffam Dickens.